I've come to here.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهد الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، we'll give thanks to all means Allah. We show our gratitude to Him. May the peace and the blessing of all Almighty Allah upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family and his companions till the day of judgment. Almighty Allah always remind us in Al-Quran Al-Azim saying, or you will believe. Fear Allah wherever you are. Fear Allah, Allah says in Al-Quran Al-Adim. And he says furthermore, and do not return to me, except you die in state of Islam. My brother and sister in Islam, inshallah, today's khutbah, I would like to draw each everyone to draw us back to Almighty Allah from what Almighty Allah has given us. What Almighty Allah has given us is hujjah, proof, is the book of Almighty Allah, Al-Quran Al-Azim. Almighty Allah knows that in this life, we will face many trials, many challenges. But Almighty Allah left Al-Quran Al-Azim for us through Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that from Al-Quran Al-Azim, we can get shifa, cure for everything. That's why Almighty Allah left Al-Quran for me and you. But if we can look into the Muslims today, we ignore Al-Quran Al-Azim. We didn't take it seriously as we're supposed to take it. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day, he said to his companions, Satakunu fitna. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, let me tell you, there will be for you a trial. Prophet Muhammad was addressing the Sahaba. And immediately, the Sahaba say, Ya Rasulullah, the Messenger of Allah, wa ma mukhrij. We heard you. We know that you are telling the truth. What wa ma mukhrij? Lead us to the way out. Tell us. Then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, this is not the magic. Kitab Allah. The book of Allah. This is the statement of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Kitab Allah is there for you. Me that stick will read. Hold on to it. Because in the past, for the past nation, like prophets that came before us, they faced the same thing with their prophets. But each everyone that Almighty Allah has created in these prophets, they have something that Almighty Allah has given them, like miracle, like sign. For instance, the people of Salim, they say to Prophet Salim, alayhi salatu wasalam, that, are you calling you as a prophet of Almighty Allah? He say, yes, I'm the prophet of Almighty Allah. Then show us the sign. Show us the sign. Then Prophet Saul, you say, okay, what's exactly sign that you need? Because in the time of Prophet Saul, Allah blessed them how to construct construction. They know about the construction too much to build the gigantic houses. Then Almighty Allah want to show them that, no, this is my prophet. Then they ask Prophet Solomon, they say, okay, look at this mountain. Let she camels come from this mountain. Because they are looking for the sign that's a miracle. That's totally different from what they have already performed. Remember, they can construct, but in this time, and they want the life from the mountain to come out. They say to Prophet Solomon, Solomon say, this is what you need. They say, yes. Then he asked Almighty Allah. Then Almighty Allah entertain them. They saw the camel, she camel, run around in their front, but still they deny Almighty Allah. They don't believe Prophet Solomon. They say, this magician. Look at the Prophet Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam. Awalau jituka bihaya, Fir'aun and his people, his follower, they said to Prophet Musa, show us your sign that we can believe that you are the messenger of Almighty Allah. Then Almighty Allah let Prophet Musa alayhi salatu wasalam turn the stick to the snake for them as a sign. And many, many signs. But instead, they deny. They deny Prophet Musa. Now, when it has come to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of the time, then Almighty Allah combined. Remember, Prophet Musa has his book, and Prophet Saul is the same thing. But in this time around, Almighty Allah combined the book and the sign together for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Any miracle that you want to see, you will see them in the book of Al-Quran al-Azim. Because Almighty Allah knows that they will still deny. They will still deny Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Almighty Allah combined everything together for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brother and sister in Islam. So that's the reason why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Kitab Allah, the book of Almighty Allah, is enough for you. Whenever you face challenges, whenever you want any cure, do not worry yourself. Back to Al-Quran Al-Azim. Recently, I saw in the TV, Asian Airlines, his destination is Malaysia. But unfortunately, for the pilot and the people in the plane, on their way, the plane was shaking, turbulence, too much for about 2 hours. No, now everyone was so panicked. Because they don't know their fate. The pilot came out and said to them by announcing that Mayday, Mayday, Mayday. The only thing that I want you to do now, just pray. the pilot said that, he announced that, just pray. My brother and sister in Islam, wallahi lazim, finally, Almighty Allah saved them. They reached their destination safely. This is my point. Only Almighty Allah knows the reason that Almighty Allah survived them. Only Allah knows. But look at the belief of this pilot saying that, just pray to Almighty Allah. Maybe because of that. Only Almighty Allah knows. Maybe because of that. And that's okay. Since you know that I'm the one, then I will save you. This is what exactly believe that Almighty Allah wants me and you to have for Al-Quran Al-Azim. Because the word of Almighty Allah came out from Almighty Allah itself. My brother and sister in Islam, in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Quraysh non-believers, they frequently asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu about the same ayah, the sign, miracle. They asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam because they knew the story about the past. They say, why can't do the same thing for us? They mention for Muhammad sallallahu many things. They asked for Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Similarly, likewise, Prophet Sali, Prophet Musa, and so on. Until Almighty Allah said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, let them know. Allah says in Surah Al-Ankabut, أَوَلَمْ يَكْفِيهِمْ أَنَّا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ يُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَرَحْمَةً لِلذِّكْرَى لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. Almighty Allah said to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, أَوَلَمْ يَكْفِيهِمْ, and it's not enough for them. This Quran is not enough for them. حَوَلَمْ يَكْفِيهِمْ أَنَّا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ, and that we, Allah, send this Al-Quran Al-Azim for you. It's not enough for them. Why are they asking for any miracle in other places? Al-Quran is enough for everything for us. Then Almighty Allah is talking to the non-believer Quraysh. But we Muslims today, we place ourselves into that position. We place ourselves into that position today. Because that Al-Quran is not reflected in our faith. Why Almighty Allah mentioned this? First of all, Al-Quran is sufficient as a sign, as a miracle. Number one. Look at Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In order for me and you to believe in this Al-Quran, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is unlettered. He cannot read. He cannot write. And look at Al-Quran Al-Azim. Where he got it? That's why Almighty Allah is challenging the Quraysh that you know the background of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Tell me the school that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went. It's on letter. He cannot read. He cannot, even if he want to write or do something, he has to call Sayyidina Ali or Abu Bakr. This is the prophet. So through this, you can know that, it's come from Almighty Allah, through the angel Jibril. And at the same time, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam never mixed with the people of book. You cannot say, oh, because he went outside, maybe in one university, that's the reason why he came back. So now, you get everything together. He can write, he can do that. No! That can tell you about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And at the same time, look at Al-Quran al-Azim. Allahu Akbar. Al-Quran can tell what is past, can tell what's the future. This is Al-Quran al-Azim. Because it came from Almighty Allah. It came from Almighty Allah. Al-Quran al-Azim can judge in every angle. And if you compare, we need the logistic reason for Al-Quran al-Azim. No, this is the word of Almighty Allah. My brother and sister in Islam, for me and you, to know that Almighty Allah has blessed me and has blessed you with Al-Quran al-Azim. That's the reason why Al-Quran negates anyone claim that I know the future, unless what Almighty Allah has let Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam know. If Almighty Allah can let us know that even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi did not know the future, why are we claiming that we have the knowledge, on clear knowledge? Why? Because many Muslims today, they claim that. Many sheikh today, they claim that. Even many Muslims, they believe on that. Look at what Almighty Allah says. Allah said to Prophet in advance, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ. Almighty Allah said to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they will come and ask you concern the hours. You're going to see some question like that. Then Almighty Allah prepared Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then Almighty Allah say, whenever that question came, cool, see, innama ilmuha indallah. That knowledge, no one knows except Almighty Allah. Except Almighty Allah. Look at the belief. So direct everything to me. Allah said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّ السَّاعَةَ تَكُونُ قَرِيبًا. And what will make you understand the hours that we are telling you? Either something gonna happen in a second to this time, or in the future, or in day of resurrection. Any form, you don't even know. Unless what I told you, oh Muhammad, that this is how, or through the angel Jibril. Without that, don't ever say anything concerning that. Allah said to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but perchance the hour is near. So when anyone say that, oh, when it is hour, mean that when is the day of the resurrection, when is the day of the resurrection? No, only Almighty Allah knows when the time of this dunya is going to be end. Only Allah has that knowledge. Almighty Allah to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My brother and sister in Islam, These are Al-Quran al-Azim. In fact, in Al-Quran al-Azim, Allah says to Prophet Muhammad, let the Quraysh know, even including us, Almighty Allah bless us. Since Almighty Allah has given Prophet Muhammad Al-Quran al-Azim, till now, we cannot even produce the same thing like Al-Quran al-Azim. We are asked Almighty Allah challenge with our intellect, with our understanding. We are asked Almighty Allah says in Al-Quran al-Azim, Allah say, let them produce similar like Al-Quran al-Azim. Almighty Allah says they cannot. Then Almighty Allah says again, in four forms that Almighty Allah mentioned like that. Okay, let them produce only 10 surah. They cannot, Allah says, answer for that. Okay, let them produce only one. Almighty Allah, they will not. Look at the power of Al-Quran al-Azim, my brothers and sisters in Islam. So meaning that no one knows what is going to happen to him in a second. Only Almighty Allah knows. In one hadith, famous hadith, Angel Jibril appeared to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the form of a man. Very famous hadith that Sayyidina Umar related. Then this angel said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tell me about Islam. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered, tell me about the article of faith. Then Prophet Muhammad alayhi wa sallam said, tell me about his son. Prophet Muhammad alayhi wa sallam answered that. And each every question, this angel said, you have spoken the truth. You have spoken the truth. You have spoken the truth. Until then he said, now, Ya Muhammad, tell me about the day of resurrection. Then now Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the questioner even have the knowledge of that than the someone that is asking from. Mean that Angel Jibril has more knowledge on that than even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not answer that. Prophet did not answer that. Now the angel Jibril shifted and he said, okay, what about the sign? Now Almighty Allah has given Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about that in many, many forms that we can know the sign of the day of resurrection. So now Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned only two.